So we completed all these setups in the last session. So we created business unit and we assigned business functions, which allows us to complete the relevant areas of application configuration. And to create the employee user, we require legal entity and operating unit. Those definitions are ready, but the legal entity, whatever we assign to employee user, that has to be associated with the legislated data group. The legislated data group purpose is the payroll purpose. We create legislated data group. So since that mapping is not available by default, you don't see in any environment, we have to create the legislated data group that we have to assign to legal entity. So that legal entity, if you assign to employee user definition, system will accept. Without assigning the legislated data group with the legal entity, you cannot select the legal entity for employee user definition. So once you create the employee user, the same information system will sync with the security console. From security console, you can find the employee user definition and what are the roles we require for that user, those we have to assign. In our case, we assigned all the roles, which roles we assigned to our previous user. And we provided data access also for the same users, same user related roles. The roles which we assigned to our user, which are related to GL, for those GL roles, we assigned our primary ledger and we submitted LDAP job. LDAP job for role synchronization. So now from this user, what are the setups we are going to perform? We'll perform all the setups from our current user only. The current user is ERP cloud. ERP cloud is employee user. Okay, employee user, done. So now what we'll do is we'll convert the ERP cloud employee user as a procurement agent, nothing but buyer as per EBS. So if you want to create, say, purchase order, you have to create that employee as a buyer, then only you can create the purchase order. Here, not only purchase order, even if you want to create supplier sites, if you want to create the supplier site from specific user, the user should be employee user, and again that user need to be classified as a buyer. Here the same buyer we are calling as procurement agent. So we have to create the procurement agent. We have to convert the employee user as a procurement agent. We'll see what setups we are going to perform. So create procurement agent. Why we have to create procurement agent? We are not going to work on purchasing as of now. Even if you are not going to work on purchasing, for supplier site definition, if you want to create the supplier site, the user should be a procurement agent. So that is the reason we are going to create. So at the time of location creation and business unit creation, we have seen concept called as set. Location creation time, location set. Business unit creation time, default set we have seen. The set is nothing but reference data set. Okay, we'll talk about what is a reference data set, how it works. If you want to create our own reference data set, how to create, where we have to assign, we'll just focus on those points. Okay, say create reference data set. Create reference data set. You can call it as RDS. I have to create reference data set and we will test the reference data set by associating with the payment terms. In EBS, the payment terms directly you can create, those would be available for any operating unit. But in the Fusion, so without reference data set mapping, you cannot use any payment terms. So since the reference data concept is mandatory for payment terms, here we'll test how the reference data set works in this environment. Say create payment terms. We'll discuss more detail level. We'll discuss more detail since I'm listing out the setups. I'm very high level addressing. We'll go one by one. We'll discuss and we'll do in the system. Create payment terms and assign to RDS, reference data set. The same reference data set we have to assign to business unit also. say assign reference data set to business unit. Okay, after completing these setups, we'll set up common options. As per EBS, we have financials options. Financial options for what purpose? For primarily for payables and purchasing. The same financial options, the naming convention here you could see as a common options. We'll take the task as configure common options for payables and procurement. This setup is equal to EBS financials options, and within the EBS we have a payable options. With the payable options, you can do the setups related to invoice process and the payment process. In Fusion, they given separate tasks to set up invoice related setups and the payment related setups. I mean to say, which we set through payable options in EBS, that they separated for invoicing and do payment. So the same payable options which you see in EBS, that they given in the Fusion as a two different options. Those are invoice options and do payment options. Say setup invoice options. Say setup payment options. After completing these setups, we'll go and create the distribution sets. We'll create the distribution sets. And in EBS, you can create the supplier directly. But in the Fusion, from which user you have to assign the supplier related role. Which user has access to supplier related role, that user only can create the supplier. So to create the supplier, we have to assign the role to our user. Say assign supplier role. Just I am writing a supplier role. If you want to take the exact name, anyway, we'll see in the system process. But if you want to take the name, the role name is supplier manager. So for our current user, we assign the different roles: application implementation consultant, IT security manager, employee, general accountant, accounting, general accounting manager, controller. These are the different roles we assign. In the same way, we have to assign the role called as supplier manager role to our user, so that our user will be able to create the supplier. You may assign supplier role to one user, but the user may not be in the position. The system may not allow that user to create supplier. The reason is, if the user is not a employee user and if user is not a procurement agent, even if you assign the supplier manager role, that user cannot create the supplier definition. Remember, if you have one user XYZ, if the XYZ user wants to create the supplier, first of all, the XYZ user should be a employee user. Because of employee user, that XYZ user cannot create the supplier definition. The same employee user should act as a procurement agent. Okay, there is one user called as XYZ. XYZ user is employee user as well as procurement agent. This user will be able to create the suppliers? No. So for the same user, you have to assign the role called as supplier manager. If these three conditions are meeting, the user will be able to create the supplier. Okay, So this is a point we have to understand. Okay. Fine. Fine. So we have to assign the role called as supplier manager to user. We have to assign the supplier manager role to user. So after that, once you assign, you can create the supplier definition. So you'll create the supplier, and you say supplier header, and in EBS, along with the supplier, we'll create the supplier site. At the time of site, we provide the address. For the same address, we'll give the site name. But here, we have to create the address as a separate definition. First, we'll create the supplier. Then we'll create the supplier address. And we'll create the site. Then site will assign site to BU, business unit. So when you assign the site to BU, there are some conditions which are applicable here. We'll discuss as a part of supplier definition. Okay, now those are not required. Fine. So we have to complete all these setups. After completing these setups, so system will allow us to process the invoices. If you open the periods, to create the payments, we have to do the payment related configuration also. Okay, that also we'll see. And one more point here, if you are going to work on the fresh instance, you have to set up supplier numbering also. Set supplier numbering. In case of EBS, we can set the supplier numbering if it is 11i, it is 11i through financial options, you can set. In EBS release 12, you can set by using the payable system setup. From there you can set, but in Fusion you cannot set from the common options or any one of these options. We have a separate task to set the supplier numbering. In the fresh instance, if you don't set the number, you cannot create the supplier. Okay, there's no option to set the manual numbering. It's automatic numbering we have to set up. We'll see that. So the instance which you are using for practice, that is vision instance. Already in the vision instance, you can find out that definition is already completed. So even if you don't set the supplier number, you will be able to create the supplier. When it comes to fresh instance, you have to set it up. Otherwise, you cannot create the supplier. When you are trying to create the supplier, it won't give you the message as supplier number you have to configure. It will give some message which we cannot understand. But only the point we have to remember is we have to set the supplier number before you create the supplier definition. Fine. So we'll list out some other setups also which you have to complete. First, we'll complete these setups. After completing the setups, we'll look at the bank branch, bank account creation, payment process, profile definitions. Okay, other required setups, opening the periods. We'll discuss and we'll complete. First, we'll start with these setups. After completing these setups, we'll see other setups which we have to perform as a part of payables, which are basic setups. Based on the concept which you are going to handle, if any additional setups are required, we'll perform and we'll test that relevant functionality. We'll see that. So first, we have to create our employee user as a procurement agent. Go to project. Go to implementation project. Search for the task called as procurement agent. Procurement agent, nothing but buyer. Click on manage procurement agent. Click on go to task icon. Fine. So when you create the procurement agent, we have to create for specific business unit so that that procurement agent will be able to perform the transactions only for that BU, and that procurement agent can create supplier sites and can assign to only that business unit. Okay, we'll see. In EBS, it's very simple. We'll go to the buyer's page. We'll add our employer as a buyer. That's all. But here, we can set different controls and we can give the permissions. This procurement agent can do what and which transaction creation is not allowed for the procurement agent. We can specify all this. We'll see that. Click on create. So select procurement BU. Which business unit is procurement business unit? For which business unit we enabled procurement business function? We created a business unit and we enabled business functions. So for our business unit, we enabled all the functions. That means our business unit, procurement business unit. Which business unit we call as procurement business unit? For which business unit we enable procurement business function, that BU will act as a procurement BU. If you see your business unit in this list, that means you enabled procurement business function. If you don't see your business unit here, that means after creating the business unit for our BU, we have to understand we did not assign any, we did not enable procurement business function. Okay, that's how system will allow or don't allow to perform the relevant setups if you don't enable the relevant business function for a particular BU. So we can find our BU in this list. The reason for our business unit, we enabled or say we assigned business function called as procurement. You can see the reason is we assigned business function called as procurement for our BU. So ERP Cloud US Business Unit. So we want to create which employee as a procurement agent. Select that employee. Employee name is same, right? ERP Cloud. And if you want to allow this, when this employee is going to work on the procurement process and when that employee is going to create the requisitions, if you want to default specific requisitioning BU, you can select here but not mandatory. If you select, it will default whenever this user is going to create the requisition. Otherwise, we have to select. You can select it. So for the same business unit, if you enable the checkbox called as requisitioning BU, requisitioning business function, then only you can see the same BU as a requisition BU. For our business unit, we enabled all the business functions. And default printer, when this procurement agent is going to prepare any documents, the requisitions, purchase orders or any agreements, so if the agent wants to print those documents, you may specify default printer here. When it comes to printer setups in Fusion, we cannot configure the printer how we do in EBS. In case of EBS, our DBA can do the printer installation and the configuration within the system environment. The printer related configuration can be done by DBA. In case of Fusion, Oracle is not giving that option to us. If you want to configure printer related setups in the instance, you have to raise SR to Oracle and they'll ask you for some information related to your printer. Accordingly, they will configure and you can start using that printer. Okay, this is the difference you have to understand when you compare with EBS on-premise and Fusion Cloud with respect to this printing process and all. The same is applicable for any document printing. If you want to print receivables invoices or if you want to print payables, payments, checks or anything. So if you want to integrate, if you want to set up the printer, you have to contact Oracle. You have to raise SR They'll ask for the information, the URL, etc. All the details they'll be asking, you have to provide. So then they'll configure, then you can start using. Done. So here within this environment, no printer is available. Okay, no printer is installed, the configuration is not at all done. So ignore it, anyway, not mandatory. That is anyway default printer, that's all. Now here you can see this procurement agent can have access to which documents? Agent access, manage requisitions. By default, all are enabled. If I disable, this agent cannot create the requisitions. If I disable purchase orders, even you created ERP cloud as a procurement agent, this agent, ERP cloud agent, cannot create the purchase orders or else agreements. Other than standard purchase order, we have a purchase agreements. Okay, blanket, planned contract, purchase agreements we have. So those agreements, you want to allow this agent to create only standard purchase order, you can enable this. If you don't want to allow to perform the, create the purchase agreements, uncheck, so that this agent cannot create. In the same way, when it comes to core procurement, so negotiations and sourcing related, so these all these different areas you can set whether you want to allow this agent to have access or not. Even here we have a manage suppliers. So if I disable it, even this user is procurement agent, this user cannot create the supplier definition. Manage suppliers. So from this user, you cannot create the suppliers. So that is the reason, just you can make by default system select all as allowed. You can accept the same. So more if you are going to work on procurement side, generally we set the preferences. We want to allow this user is working on which relevant process, accordingly we will set the permissions. And say here we are giving the permissions for all these documents and areas of access. If you want to allow this, say for example, this user is going to create the purchase orders. Along with the creating the purchase order, if you want to allow the same agent to see other agent related purchase documents, you can set the permission. So this user will create the purchase orders, and the same purchase orders the same user can see, they can modify and they can take any action on that. And if you want to allow this agent to access other agent documents, other procurement agent documents, which other agent procurement agent documents? Any other procurement agent document, not specific other agent documents, you can set the, you can give the access from here. If you say view, this procurement agent can view other agent related documents. Other agent document, which documents? Only purchase orders. The purchase orders which are created by other procurement agent, those can be accessed by this agent, but view only access, read only access. If you set question,
yeah, when you say other procurement agent within that operating within that business unit only, right? Not the other agent,
it's operating unit because okay. First of all, this agent has access to only this procurement, this business unit within that BU only. Yes, that condition is applicable. If you set view only read only access, okay, the complete definition is only for this BU only, BU under this agent. And if you set modify, okay, if you set modify, the documents which are created by other agent, this agent can modify the data, just modification. If you set full, along with the modification, modification means modifying the data within the record, what are the data is there that can be modified. You can change some values or you can change some field information and you can, the agent can do. Instead of, you can go on mute please, somebody is on unmute, I can hear some noise. I think Vidya called. Fine, no issues. So here, instead of selecting modify, if you select full, full access will give the additional privileges like this agent can take the actions on the other agent document, means cancelling the document, placing the hold on the document. If you select modify, data modifications only within the document, but this agent cannot take some action on that. If you select full, so this agent can view or you can modify the data within the document, and on the document this agent can take the action also. The same rule is applicable wherever access to other agent documents is applicable. Okay, but this information is not required. We are not going to work on some purchasing side, but we'll be creating the requisitions, purchase orders, but we don't focus on all the aspects. Just to test P2P cycle, we'll be working on that. So just try to understand this point, what points are connected and related to procurement agent. So by default, system will enable all the areas of access. Yes, please.
Okay. Yes, how to add additional BUs for a agent?
How to add additional BUs to
the agent? How can we give multiple BUs access
the
to
same setup? You can perform one more time by selecting one more other BU.
Okay.
Now I'm making this.
Can't we give access to different BUs altogether?
You cannot list out that. Varakli is not given function in that way. Otherwise, we can do it. Okay, it's a BU specific setup. Now we are creating this employee as a procurement agent for this BU. If you want to create one more, if you want to make this employee as a procurement agent for another BU, you have to perform the same setup by selecting the different BU one more time. Now I can say save and create another. I can make this agent, this employee as a procurement agent for other BU. Okay. And complete the setup. This is how you can.
So in this case, when we are searching the agent, it will show two BUs against the agent name.
Sorry?
In this case, if you're searching the agent, it will show two BUs assigned against the agent.
Where you search for the agent, generally we don't search for the here in within
no, the order. In the same page, create.
Yes. Not in the same page. This is the definition page. Prior to that, we have a home page. Once you navigate, click on create procurement agent, it will open the page. Here, if you search with this agent, yes, it will show this agent, this user is acting as an agent for how many BUs, it will list out. Here, by default, it's showing all. Now, we created only one, ERP cloud. This agent is acting as a procurement agent for how many BUs, it will list out. Only one. The second record, we didn't save. Okay. This is how you can
save.
Yeah, done. Fine. This is all about procurement agent definition. Even if you are going to work on financials, it's a mandatory setup. Without this definition, you cannot create the supplier definition, including address and assignments. Hope this is clear. Fine. And one more point here. Now we made our employee as an agent for only one BU. So the BU is ERP Cloud US Business Unit. Now say this agent is going to create site 1. This agent wants to assign the site 1 to 4 BUs. Possible, right? In EBS 11.8 is not possible. From EBS R12 that is possible. Same is applicable in Fusion also. This agent created site 1. And the site 1, the agent is assigning to ERP Cloud US Business Unit. Say we have few more business units. We have UK Business Unit and we have India Business Unit. We have 3 BUs. Now this current user we created as agent only for US Business Unit. So So the agent will create the site. The site the agent can assign to US business unit. If this agent wants to assign the site to UK and India business unit, it is not possible. Since the agent is not acting as a procurement agent for those UK and India business unit. Still, if the agent wants to assign the site to these two BUs, first we have to create that agent as a procurement agent for these two BUs, then only that agent can assign that site to those two BUs also. Just remember this point. Okay, any questions here to understand this point, please? So system will allow that agents to assign the site to any business unit based on which BU that agent is acting as a or is acting as a procurement agent. User is acting as a procurement agent. Done. Fine. We created procurement agent. Now let's talk about reference data sets. We'll go with a simple example. Say we have payment terms, say immediate. So we created payment terms like immediate, net 45, net 30, different payment terms. So if you create the payment terms, can we access these payment terms from all the operating units in EBS, or the payment terms are specific to operating units as per EBS? Anyone please? How payment terms logic works in EBS in terms of access?
It's BU wise.
No, I'm not talking about fusion, referring BU.
Okay. Operating unit.
Operating. You mean
operating
unit wise?
No, once the payment terms are created, they are available over the instance.
Exactly. That is the point. These are not specific to operating unit. That could be 11i or release 12. So at the time of payment term, you don't need, you don't select anything. Ideally, you just go to that window and you'll create it. So the payment term, whatever you create, can be shared across instance. So when it comes to fusion, the rule is not applicable. So which payment term you want to allow for which business unit, you have to specify. Say we have these three payment terms. In EBS 11i or R12, if you create the payment term, you can select the payment term for any operating unit related invoices. All the payment terms which are created in that window, it would be available across. But in the fusion, say you have a three payment terms and you have a multiple BUs, say BU1, BU2 and BU3. You have a three business units or two business units, any example you can take. So we have these three payment terms. My requirement is I want to allow this BU1 to have access to immediate payment term only. I don't want to allow the BU1 to have access to this two. By default, no BU will have access to payment terms in the fusion without performing the required setup. If I want to allow this BU1 to have access to immediate payment term, what we have to do is, if this is the EBS scenario, three payment terms will be available from three operating units. But in the fusion, what we have to do is, you have to create reference data set. You have to create reference data set. Reference data set. let me write it. RDS. Okay. With a reference data set only, you can allow specific BU to have access to one or multiple payment terms. We take this simple example. Our requirement is BU1 require access to immediate payment term. Now what we have to do is, first we have to create the reference data set. Then you have to assign this immediate payment term to reference data set. Now if you assign this reference data set to BU1, the BU1 can have access to immediate payment term with the help of this reference data set. If BU3 also required access to only immediate payment term, the same reference data set you can assign. Okay, that's how the BU will have access. Now this is how you treat as this is reference data set 1. I'm going to create one more reference data set. That is a reference data set 2. So BU2 require access to immediate payment term and net 45 payment term, not to net 30, not required. Only two payment terms access required for BU2. Now what we have to do is, to give the access to BU2 for those two payment terms, we have to create the separate reference data set, assign this immediate payment terms to reference data set 2, and assign net 45 payment term also to reference data set 2. Now we assigned immediate and net 45 payment terms to reference data set. Now if you assign this reference data set to BU2, BU2 will have access to two payment terms. You can assign the same reference data set 2 to BU3 also. If you assign this reference data set to BU3, BU3 will have access to two payment terms. Okay. And the other requirement is BU2 need access to all payment terms. You can create one more reference data set that you can call as reference data set 3. And BU2 require access to all payment terms. By default, no BU can have access to payment terms in Fusion. So now what we have to do? We have to assign three payment terms to this reference data set. Assign immediate and assign net 45 and assign net 30 also to the same. Now these three payment terms access is required for BU2. Now you assign this to this. And BU1 is required access to only immediate payment term. That is the reason we created separate reference data set. We assigned immediate payment terms to reference data set that you can assign to BU1. And BU3 require access to only two payment terms. Those are immediate and net 45. Those we just associated with this reference data set that you can assign here. So this is how we can provision payment terms access to BUs through reference data set concept. That means we are using the reference data set to group the payment terms to provide the access to business unit. Okay. So that is the purpose we are using. Ideally, this reference data set concept we use to group the setup data. Payment term is setup data. The same way reference data set is applicable for many other definitions. We'll see going forward wherever it is applicable, we'll see. Already we have seen this reference data set at the time of location creation and business unit creation also. Okay. So first let's try to understand how it is applicable for payment terms. Same logic is applicable for everything. We'll test it. Any question here to understand the purpose of reference data set, please?
Yeah,
if three business units require access to all the payment terms, what we have to do?
Assign RDS VT to all.
Which RDS has, or else for which RDS all the payment terms are associated, that RDS we have to assign to all the BUs, that's all. For one BU, you can associate only one RDS. Okay, one BU, we can associate only one RDS. Now, if you look at this example, BU1 required access to only one payment term. So we create a reference data set and we assigned immediate. Now BU1 is required access to one more payment term called as net 30. So in that case, it's very simple. You have to assign, already reference data set is assigned to BU1. So to the same reference data set, you have to assign net 30 payment term so that this BU1 will have access to immediate and net 30 through this reference data set. So this is the concept of reference data set. Okay, how it will behave in the system environment. Okay, so we take an example of payment term. In the same way, we'll see some other.
So basically, as a good practice, it is required to create as many RDS, as many you have the BU. In case if even in the future, if there is a requirement that there will be some restriction on the payment terms,
you can change it. You can change the reference data set assignment at BU level. You can change any time.
Laxman, is one RDS applicable for only one BU, like it is unique for every business unit, right?
Yeah, you can assign one reference data set only for one BU.
Okay. Yeah.
And for one BU, one only you can assign. Reference data set is applicable for many concepts. Again, BU level, concept wise, you can assign separate. 2 points. We created business unit. At the time, we selected reference data set called as common, right? So for which concepts reference data set is applicable, for all the concepts system will use the same. For payment terms purpose, if I want to change, I can change. We'll see that when once we complete this setup, you can understand that. Assign RDS to business unit. There will be concept called as the data specification, which is set of data that is applicable. There you can understand. But at the time of BU creation, one only you can select. The same is applicable for everything. But based on the concept, now we are talking about reference data set for payment terms. Reference data set for payment terms, you can use only one reference data set for specific BU related payment terms concept. That's how it is, only one. So in terms of data objects, means concepts, wherever it is applicable, you can use different also. For one BU, for one specific area of definition, only one. Once we complete the setup, this point you can understand more detail level, but concept wise, how the logic works, we can discuss now. Okay, any questions here to understand this point, please? No questions. So now what we'll do is we'll go and create the reference data set. Okay, it's just simple definition. You have to provide the name. So go to project, or from outside of the project also you can create it. Say reference data set. Search for reference data sets. So manage reference data sets. Click on manage reference data sets. Click on go to task icon. So by default, in the first instance, you can find only two predefined reference data sets. Those are, one is common. The The other one is enterprise. These two you can see in the fresh instance. This is a visual instance. There are many which are created for practice purpose. In fresh instance, you can find by default two only. Okay, when you are going to do some automation, you are going to create your business units automatically through rapid implementation sheet or with some other concept. So system will use a common reference data set called as common. Okay, for any definitions, by default system will take common. So based on our requirement, we can create and we can use it. Fine. So click on create. To create our own reference data set, click on create. I think that open field on top. That we can refresh this. We cancel this. Open. You say create. Set code. ERP cloud. This reference data set we are creating only for the payment terms purpose, or else this reference data set you may want to use for your specific BU for all the areas. However you require, you can do it. Let's write the name as ERP cloud US BU. ERP cloud US BU business unit set. Okay, say save and close. We created reference data set. Now what we'll do is we'll go and create the payment term. Just we have to provide the name. Now we'll go and create the payment terms. Search for the task called as payment terms. We'll talk about payment terms. System will display the payment terms related to receivables also with a different task. Okay, this is the receivables payment terms. Rest all refers payment terms which we use in from purchasing as well as payables. Fine. Click on manage payment terms. Click on go to task icon. See, since scope selection is required here, it is asking. Okay. Even see, if you manage procurement agent creation time, if you provide the BU or any other cases, if you provide the BU, it won't ask. But don't think this is a BU specific. Just as a scope, it is asking. Reason, the same scope it will use for other tasks where scope selection is required. We'll see at the time of definition, you can see BU is not applicable. But when we are trying to navigate, it will ask. Because for the this task is part of one task list. Within the task list, what are the other tasks we have? Those required BU selection. When you are performing any one of the tasks within the task list, it will ask for the BU selection so that the same BU will be applicable wherever scope is applicable within the task list of tasks. So we are in the manage payment terms page. So we'll go and create the payment term. Click on create. The payment terms are not specific to BU by default, right? So nowhere BU field. Just to navigate to that page, system is asking since some other tasks are required payment business unit within the task list. That's all. So here we can create the payment term called as ERP cloud. So net 10. So installments, same as it is how we create an EBS, same process you can follow. Installments, click on add. So we give a net 10. say 100% we have to pay within 10 days. That's all. So if you want to set the discounts in EBS, you can set the three levels of discount. Same is applicable here. This section is first level discount. This section is second level discount. This is third level discount. If you want to set the discounts, you can set. Now we created payment term. Now this payment term, if you want to use, you have to assign to reference data set. That reference data set you have to assign to business unit. So we created payment term. How to assign these payment terms to reference data set? If you scroll a little down, you can see set assignments. Click on add. Click on add to assign this payment term to specific reference data set. Here to open the field to select reference data set. So this payment term we want to assign to which reference data set? We give a name as ERP Cloud, right? This is the name we give it. ERP Cloud USBU. Select it. Say save and close. So along with this, if you want to assign other payment terms also to our reference data set, yes, we can do it. Say we want to assign immediate payment term also to our reference data set. Click on payment term. So assign this immediate payment term to our reference data set. If you notice, the immediate payment term is assigned to many reference data sets. So we'll assign to our reference data set also. Click on add, assign to our reference data set. So when you are performing the setups within this environment, system by default, it will try to derive immediate payment term only. It will try to default. So when you are creating your own reference data set also, make sure that you are just assigning the immediate payment term to your reference data set so that there won't be an issue. What system is trying, what permissions you've given, those will match. Say save and close. Now we assign two payment terms to our reference data set. Two payment terms to our reference data set. So already we created payment terms, business unit, right? We'll go to our business unit. Manage business unit. Manage business units. Click on go to task icon. Find our business unit. Click on name, or else click on edit by selecting the record. It will open the definition how we created. At the time of business unit creation, we used set. Name is default set, nothing but reference data set only. We used common. Okay, just notice this. Just notice, as we used common reference data set as at the time of BU creation. We completed these two setups. Reference data set we created and we assigned to. We created payment terms and we assigned to reference data set. Now we have to assign the reference data set to business unit. Assigning the reference data set to business unit means not at the time of BU creation. The task which you are referring, that is different. So to perform that, go to project, go to implementation project. ERP cloud implementation project. Here search for the task called as assign reference data assignments. You can find the task business unit set assignments. Business unit set assignment. The task name is business unit set assignments. Search with this term. So manage business unit set assignments. By using this task, you can assign the reference data set to your business unit. So this business unit is definition type. Based on this definition, it will just associate the same reference data set wherever reference data set is concept is applicable. We'll see that. Okay, we completed reference data set assignment. We created payment terms and we assigned the payment terms to reference data set. Now we want to assign the reference data set to our business unit. Whatever we created, we want to assign. So for that, you have to use the task called as manage business unit set assignments. Click on the task. This is the task, manage business unit set assignments. Click on go to task icon. Now you have to select business unit for which BU we want to assign reference data set assignments. Click on apply and go to task. Find our business unit. So this is our business unit. Here you can see the reference data set concept, the logic is applicable for which areas it is showing. In payables, apply hold reasons, cancellation reasons, across all the applications, which applications are specific to BU. BU level works for all the applications. So these are the different concepts where reference data set concept is applicable. You see in receivables, there are many concepts. Receivables, transaction types, transaction sources, receivables, payment terms, memo line, logbox related, all these cases, this reference data set is applicable. That means you can, by using the reference data set for all these concepts, you can segregate and maintain the data instead of keeping as a common data for BUs. Fine. At the time of business unit creation, we selected common set. That is the reason for all these reference data concept related data objects, system is using the common only. So for one BU, you can assign only one reference data set. So if you want to maintain the separate reference data sets for each BU, you have a 10 BUs, BU wise you want to maintain these setup data. In that case, create 10 reference data sets. When you are creating the BU1, select BU1 reference data set. For each BU, you can select separate reference data set at BU creation time. Otherwise, even if you use the same reference data set, for which data you want to maintain configuration separately for a particular business unit, accordingly you can change here. So I don't want to use common reference data set for our BU for payment terms. Only for payment terms. For remaining all, I want to use common only. Go to payment terms. Payables payment terms. BU creation time we selected common. That is the reason for everything, for all the reference data object related areas, it is taking common only. But for payment terms purpose, we created separate reference data set that you can assign here. If you assign common, common is already we selected here, system taken. For with the common to common reference data set, how many payments are assigned, all this business unit will have access. But we don't require. We require two payment terms only. Two payment terms we assign to our own reference data set that you can select here. So that this BU will have access to only those payment terms which payment terms are associated with the selected reference data set for payment terms. ERP cloud search select save. Now this business unit will get connected to this reference data set whenever this BU from this BU user is going to select payment terms. This is how for the different areas you can set the different reference data sets, or else irrespective of BU you want to have access to everything, you can go with a common. Whatever you create in your system, whatever the payment term you create, you assign to common reference data set so that BU can have access to all the payment terms which are associated to the common. Now we are just creating our own reference data set. To our own reference data set we assigned our payment terms, and that reference data set we are assigning to BU for the specific reference data object, that is payment term. Now from this BU, if you are going to have access to payment terms, system will look at this reference data set. Within to this reference data set, how many payment terms are assigned, only those can be accessed by this business unit. So this is the point we have to understand. Any questions to understand this, please? The same way, you can create n number of reference data sets to manage specific setup data. So when I'm going to when we work on receivables, I want to allow this business unit to have access to only two payment type transaction types. Two transaction types. In that case, I can create separate reference data set. We will create two payment terms. Two payment terms only will assign to that reference data set. That reference data set, if you select here, this BU, from this BU, if you are going to record the transactions in receivables, you will be able to have access to only two transaction types. Or how many transaction source you want to allow this BU to have access, accordingly you can create reference data set for transaction types and transaction sources, assign those transaction types to transaction type reference data set, assign transaction sources to transaction source reference data set, those you select here, so that the BU will, when from that BU if you are going to have access to transaction sources, it will verify which reference data set is associated at BU level. To that reference data set, how many transaction sources are assigned, those only can be accessed by this business unit. So this is how you can manage your setup data across the business units or for specific business unit by defining the reference data set. Any questions here, please?
Hi Lakshman, through these two default reference data sets, common and enterprise, what is the difference between these two?
No difference. So just they given that two names. Common in by naming meaning itself, it is a common, which ideally Oracle also will use any automation processes. Enterprise, for maybe you may just create separate reference data sets, some country wise. In that aspect, just they given the name as enterprise, that's all. But ideally, for any configuration, any automation, by default Oracle uses common. And again, when we are going to define something in the system, minimum one reference data set is required to complete many setups. So that is the reason they are given common. See, we created business unit. Before we create business unit, if no common reference data set, at least one reference data set is not available, you cannot complete the business unit creation. At the time of business unit creation, the default set is mandatory. So That is the reason the default one they created. But reality, when you do the implementation, you are okay to access any data, any setup data from specific operating unit, you can go with the common. And whatever you define, wherever reference data set is applicable, you assign to common. Since you are using the common here, this BU will have access to the relevant data which is available, which is associated the common. Otherwise, if you want to maintain these areas of data specific to business units, create BU specific reference data sets, and at the time of BU creation itself, you have to select here. Once you create the business unit, you cannot overwrite. Say you created business unit and you selected common. Later you just you are planning, you want to use BU specific reference data set. In that case, what you have to do, go to this page and change reference data set to all these reference data objects. In all the reference data objects, change override with your new reference data set which you created for your BU. You may select here ERP Cloud US BU set. For all you can select, that would be equal to selecting here. If you select here, that will default it. If you want to change for some reference data object, you can change, or else for if you want to change for everything, you can change accordingly. You can define the relevant definitions and you can assign wherever those are applicable. Any questions, please?
So right now we have basically this, you have access to two RDS, which is common and ERP Cloud U.
This BU has access to common for these areas of data, and this BU has access to this only for payment term related data. Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, but BU creation time only one reference data set. So this will get defaulted wherever reference data set concept is applicable. For which concept, which reference data set you want to use, you can create and you can use accordingly. Any questions here, please?
Laxman, reference data set, whatever we created for payment terms, we can use the same reference data set for other areas also.
Same reference data set you can assign to other BUs also. Yes.
Okay. Laxman, here there is some receivable source, right? Can I use the same reference data set for a receivable source area also? Whatever I created for payment term.
Whatever you created for?
Payment term, can I use the same for receivable?
Just name, right? This is the common is used for everything, right?
Yes.
The same way you can use this also. You can use here also. But when you create the transaction sources, you have to assign those transaction sources to this reference data set only. Then there will be.
Yes.
Okay. Then this BU will be able to have access. Just you are using this name. But for this, you assign only payment terms, means this BU can have access to payment terms through this. If you are assigning the same reference data set for transaction types and transaction sources, assign the transaction types and sources to this reference data set at the time of definition. Then this BU can have it. Possible.
Lishitha, earlier you said in the session today that one RDS can be assigned to one BU only.
One RDS can be assigned to one BS. This RDS here, how many RDSs you can assign? This is the point I refer.
Okay.
No, see, one RDS can be assigned to one BU. That I didn't deliver that statement. RDS only you can use for BU.
Okay.
For
okay.
One BU, one only, not one reference data set for one BU only.
Okay, not vice versa, but one. Okay.
Yeah, one reference data set you can use for multiple BUs, but for one BU only one reference data set at the time of definition. But here, reference data object level you can override. Object wise you can use different RDS also. I refer definition type. Definition time for one BU you can use one reference data set only at the time of definition. Once you define, the same will default to everything. So wherever you want to change, you can use. So based on this, you can say you can associate multiple reference data set to one BU by considering this set assignment task.
Okay.
but definition time only one. But one
so for payment,
multiple BUs. Yeah, please.
So for payment, we have created one RDS, and for transaction type, we can create a separate RDS, assign both of them here.
Payment term, we created one, yes.
So for transaction type, we can create a separate one.
Yeah, separate one you create and assign to payment transaction types only here.
So here the name is, even though it is the same name common, but it is created for different purposes with the same name.
Yeah. No. Yeah, the common created, payment terms, transaction types are assigned to common name only. It's a grouping, like mapping.
Yeah. But is the common for assigned for transaction type, is the same common for transaction source?
Yes. For transaction sources also, you can assign to common.
Oh.
Anything you can assign. See, any data, these all are the different reference data set related definitions. Any data you create, you can assign to specific reference data set or multiple reference data sets. The same you have to map at BU level. That's how it will get connected.
Mm-hmm.
So it is a name not specific to one reference data object. The name you can use for any setup related data. Whenever you are doing these relevant setups, the name would be available over there, same name.
Okay,
you can map. Once you map over there, make sure that same you have in the BU level also within this setup. That's how it works.
Can you see the definition of common?
Sorry?
Can you see the definition of common, how it is defined?
Just now I opened, right? Before we create our own, I just verified, right? I just shown by searching common and enterprise. Same as this, they given the name and description.
Okay.
Same.
All right.
See that.
Also, is it necessary to assign immediate for all the reference data set? You were saying that we need to assign. I did not get that point, why it is necessary.
No, by default system will try to fetch the default one. Okay, that's how we have. Otherwise no issues, you can ignore and you can proceed. You can select your own payment terms. Since it's a vision environment, like just they made it as a default, so you can ignore it. And you can proceed with that. Even if you have multiple payment terms within that reference data set, ideally it will select immediate. Okay.
So, in a scenario where we are having a common one, and in case if you want a new payment term, suppose, then we cannot use the assign that new payment term to common, because that will be used across all the instances which are used the common one, right?
You are creating new payment terms for what purpose? For specific BU or all the BUs?
For all the BUs. For all the BUs in our, you can say for our entity.
Yeah, all the,
BUs, in the instance.
For all the BUs you need. So for all the BUs which reference data set you assign at the level of reference data that, called as payment terms, there you have to assign that reference data set.
Okay, and if I want to restrict for that view, do we have the facility to copy all the payment terms which are there in the common and include the new one?
No, that is not possible. It's a manual, you have to go and do it. Create new reference data set and go one by one and you have to assign. That's it. Copying and that we cannot manage. It's a manual process.
Okay. Anyway, it is a one-time exercise, so it should be okay.
Correct. Yep.
Thank you.
Yeah, thanks. So this is the one which we tested. Your reference data sets. Okay, common. Set code they're given as a common. Set name they're given as a common set. So see, when you are practicing, ignore to provide the description. in some instances, if you provide description, this function is not working. After creating this reference data set by providing description, if you go to payment terms to assign, it is not coming over there. Okay, that's what our experience. So ignore to provide the description. You can ignore the description. Okay, hope this point is clear to everyone. So whatever the reference data set we select at the time of BU creation, that would get defaulted to all the reference data object related areas, and you can override by creating your own and by associating the relevant data with the same. The same we did for payment terms. Done. So save and close. We assigned RDS to BU through set assignments. Okay. Okay, let's go to common options. Okay, common options. Else before that, let's go to invoice options. That setup we'll do a bit later. Go to invoice options, search for invoice options. We'll set these options later, but just to go through that point, select your business unit you want to set invoice options for which BU. ERP Cloud. Select this record and say OK. See, we are accessing, this BU has access to two payment terms only. See, by default system selected payment term as immediate. If you click on drop down, how many payment terms you can see? Only two. Okay, if you change the assignment to common, how many payment terms are assigned to common? Those many you can access from here. We assign these two only, right? Okay, we assigned two, the same two you can see, ERP Cloud Net 10 and one more which is predefined, that also we assigned. So ideally system, whenever you navigate here, system will try to fetch immediate payment term. Even it is not there in our reference data set, it will try to fetch that. If it is there, okay, or else we'll be changing to the other one. Okay, so this is how the user will be able to have access in terms of setup. Even when we are going to create invoices for this business unit, invoice creation time, we'll be able to access these two payment terms. Reason, we create a reference data set, these two only we assign to that reference data set, that reference data set we assign to this BU. Okay, this is a point we have to understand. Fine, it's almost 9:30. So we'll work on these tasks in tomorrow's session. Okay.
Lakshman, I have a question actually. So this two default means these RDS that are available, common and enterprise. Say if I created four or five payment terms in the instance. So does these common and enterprise have access to all those payment terms?
No. You have to assign. If you assign, then only those will have access. Now, okay. if you go to business unit, which BU has common reference data set access for payment terms, you don't find our payment term which we created. Okay, we created payment term, right? Just now we have seen the payment term which we created and assigned to our reference data set, that you cannot see from the common reference data set related to BU. This is available only for RBU. You have to assign. It could be any reference data set, system default reference data set or custom reference data set which we are creating. Without assigning, it won't be available from anywhere. Just names they given, that's all. Okay, just now we created instead of creating. Yeah. Any other questions? Fine. So this concept is applicable for many definitions. We'll just come across. You're working again, we can go through it, but to understand how it works, what is the purpose, that is this. So ideally what we have to understand, to segregate the setup data as per BU requirement. There are some definitions in EBS which are shared across. If you require in the similar fashion, create one reference data set. If you talk about payment terms, create one payment term, one reference data set, assign all the payment terms. You have to do it mandatory. By default, won't be available. Otherwise, if you want to restrict, so how to restrict? We already discussed. Create accordingly reference data sets and associate payment terms to the reference data sets. Assign those reference data sets to BU at the data level. If it is a payment terms, payment term, transaction types, transaction type level, data objects you can assign. Fine.
Sir, this all the setups which we are doing, it can be done by through RI also, right, sir?
Yeah, we can perform with a rapid implementation spreadsheet. I'll be covering the rapid implementation spreadsheet. We done with the business unit, right? First, we'll complete the AP setups. After completing AP setups, I'll take you through how we can how we can do these setups through rapid implementation configuration. We have a different sheet. So primary one is the ledger creation, BU's creation, legal entities creation. That is RI sheet we use ideally.
Okay. Thank you, sir. You have provided us new instance, right, sir, yesterday, because there was a issue with the deployment in the earlier instance.
Exactly. That we found that there is some issue with SBase. So the synchronization is not happening. That is the reason I shared the new instance credentials to everyone.
And one more thing is, sir, in the last instance also, where you were, one of the other guy was showing that there was an issue with the in the deployment. If we go through the error log, first of all, I am not in a position to even understand what is that error coming from also. It's a very big actually.
No, generally what happens is, most of the cases, it addresses the error with which chart of account structure, again with which segment also. It gives the error saying that, so with in so and so chart of account, the balancing label is missing, our natural account label is missing. This is how ideally we get error. Sometimes it won't, we are finding it is not tracking the purpose of the error. What purpose? What is the reason we are getting that error that is missing? Okay. But ideally, when we are working for clients and all, we don't create these many chart of accounts and there won't be any confusion. Okay, we'll have a very limited one or more than one, depends. So at that time, if there is any deployment, you can open and you can verify. We are following the rules, whatever you have to follow when you create the chart of account, minimum two segments. Of course, just with the two segments, we don't create chart of account for any client, but just the minimum rules you can verify. So there won't be an issue. Since it's a kind of test environment, people are just playing by knowing or unknowingly, they do go with different definitions. So that is causing these issues, that's all.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Fine, thanks. So any other questions on today's session or from previous session or prior classes, or from any session? If you have any questions.
Actually, we created this ERP cloud USBU our RDS, right? And we assign the payment terms.
Correct.
So we can use the same RDS to assign transaction type also, right?
The same you can use for other BUs also. This is just name for our identification purpose. We give a name like that.
No, I can assign it to other BUs. My question is, we can use the same RDS to assign transaction type along with payment?
Yes.
Okay.
Common is used for everything, right? We have seen.
Yes.
The same way, this also can be used for all. Okay, this one. Already we have seen that same. Okay. Any questions?
Lakshman, I want to go back to second session.
Yeah, please.
In that, we were discussing about job roles and duty roles. So,
yes.
Is there a way to differentiate these two? And
yeah,
when we search the role.
Yes, job roles and duty roles. Simple. In EBS, we have menu and submenu, right?
Right.
Same concept. EBS menu is equal to job role. EBS submenu is equal to duty role. Duty roles are part of job role always.
Okay.
So in our classes, we'll see. I'll take you through that. We'll open those roles and we'll create duty roles. We'll create job roles. We'll include duty roles into job roles. We'll be working on those areas. So in that introduction session, just I given that information just for understanding, but to see proof of the same, we have to work on that session. Okay.
Practicing is lagging very badly, sir, you know. that is where the thing is actually.
Yeah.
Classes are running away and we got the new instance.
No issues. We'll extend the instance access. No issues. We'll extend instance access after 3 months. Also, you can spend some time for practice. Yeah, no issues.
Yeah.
Extend it if required. Fine. So here you can select. So for every reference data object, you can select the same reference data set which we associated for payment terms. Same you can use everywhere. However, common is used for every reference data object. How system is using the common? Because we selected at BU level, it is defaulted. If you select this at BU level at the time of definition, this also will get default. Otherwise, you may use common at the time of definition. Later you can override. Everywhere you can change. You can select whatever you want to select for everything. But that is possible. You can do that. So any other questions? Fine, no questions. So we'll connect tomorrow same time and we'll continue from here. I will try to complete these options. Don't take much time, supplier. Okay.
Lakshman will be uploading this video, right? Today I missed 15 minutes.
Yeah, you can expect after 2 hours. The conversion will take minimum 2 to 3 hours time. Once that is,
okay.
I'll place in the drive immediately. Okay.
Oh,
yeah.
Thanks.
Yeah. Thank you. Okay. Fine. So that's all for today. We'll connect tomorrow and we'll continue from here. Thank you all. Have a good day and good night.